Okay, now we're going to look at the state of open source, and we're going to look at security issues with open source. And one of the reasons why I wanted to look it up is a lot. I think we're going to see some of the statistics, if not in this one, in one of the developer experience ones. It is quite clear that a vast majority of software and websites today do this like magnitude of order, exponential increase in dependency expansion, the more that you bring in libraries in order to get something accomplished. So for example, I'm going to pick on, well, I mean, you could pick on just about, you know, anything that does this, like Rust package managers. NPM is a huge source for this. You could say this about like React or like Webpack or things like, well, maybe not so much Webpack, but you know, where you're importing a bunch of stuff, right? And so a lot of these things that you're importing tend to come from open source. Now, I don't know if I have the statistics for this. This might be in a future stream, but the statistics indicate that as you increase your open source usage or your library usage, your risk factor, for example, of running into something that has an outdated license or a license where you could actually be legally or financially fined for your use of that library jumps up by like 25% within like the first web of importing your libraries. And a lot of it goes either unseen or not reported. And then once you start going up from there, you start seeing things like how much dead code do you bring in to the entirety of your project? Dead code being literally the amount of code that is literally not run or operated on the machine, whether it's server-based, client-based, or desktop-based. And it increases by, I can't remember what the numbers were, but it was something like most projects end up with something like, oh, I am going to botch up the number, but it was something like 30 to 70% dead code just sitting there that you've brought in, along with the licensing, along with potential security exploits, which, by the way, also escalate in the same amount of size, if not worse, and also go unreported or underseen, even though the industry in general does seem to be having an upward trend of dealing with their vulnerability reports, but dealing with them versus leaving the door open to them and or fixing them proactively is not the same thing as dealing with them after the fact. So I wanted to look at just general open source. What's the state of open source? Because a lot of us tend to use it, whether we know it or not, including it sometimes in like, what would you call it? Like closed source, paid for software. So these guys do, I think this is their ninth report. They did 1,067 code bases in 2023. 936 code bases underwent risk assessments. So 84% of code bases are assessed for risk contained vulnerabilities. So if you wanted to kind of like round this up to, let's say approximately 1,000, so you have, you know, nice numbers, 840 of the code bases in these repositories contain vulnerabilities. That is stupefyingly large. 74% of code bases assessed for risk contained high risk vulnerabilities, which is even more stupefyingly large. 96% of the total code bases contained open source. So there we go. That's a huge number of people using open source software. 77% of all code in the total code bases originated from open source. 53% of the total code bases contained license conflicts. You, when you use NPM or when you use a library or a framework or whatever that's importing a bunch of this stuff, you are taking this on as part of your baggage. And if you're a company that wants to make money and that pays out money to their developers, to software, to whatever, this is baggage that you're taking on without you even knowing about it. 31% of the total code base contained open source with no license or a custom license. 14% of the code bases assessed for risk contain vulnerabilities older than 10 mother effing years. 2.8 years was the mean age of vulnerabilities in the code bases assessed for risk. 49% of the code bases assessed for risk had components that had no development activity in the past 24 months. 1% of the code bases assessed for risk had components that were at least 12 months behind on code maintainer updates and patches. This one is not so bad. 91% of the code bases assessed for risk contained components that were 10 versions or more behind the most current version of the component. Figure 1. 1,067 code bases scanned by industry, percentage of code bases containing open source. So this will be in yellow, and percentage of code bases containing code originating from open source. This will be in this bluish color. 100% of these industries have code bases that use open source. 69% have code that originates from open source. So aerospace, aviation, automotive, transportation, and logistics. Computer hardware and semiconductors, even more so on both counts. I mean, not more so on 100%. Internet and mobile apps, about the same as the other industries up top. Internet and software infrastructure, the same as internet and mobile apps. I don't know why they have internet and software infrastructure here twice, but in any case, Internet of Things, manufacturing, industrials, and robotics, that's really high. Marketing tech, also really high. So again, the yellow is uses open source, originates from open source. Retail and e-commerce uses open source, originates from open source. Telecom and wireless, enterprise software, SaaS, financial services and fintech, VR, gaming, entertainment and media. Now we start to see a bit of a drop. Big data, AI, BI, machine learning, there's a little bit of a drop. Cybersecurity, a little tiny bit of a drop. EdTech, tiny bit of a drop. Energy and clean tech, more so of a drop. Healthcare, health tech, and life sciences, the lowest. Okay, so then they talk about what they did in terms of like their analysis and what they're looking for. 84% of code bases contained at least one open source vulnerability. In 2022, you had a 48% code bases containing high risk vulnerabilities. In 2023, it jumped up to 74%. That is a 54% increase in vulnerabilities in open source. There is no single answer for the 54%, 26 percentage points in high-risk vulnerabilities. One possible explanation is the economic downturn and consequent layoffs, which reduced the number of resources available to locate and patch vulnerabilities. Additionally, 91% of the code bases were found to contain components 10 versions or more behind the most current available version of the component. So they're like, we don't know. We don't know. Eight of the top 10 vulnerabilities map to one pillar CWE, CWE 707, that is a single vulnerability, which addresses security requirements that are not being met and can lead to exploits such as cross-site scripting and SQL injection. And here is 707. It is improper neutralization, which includes things like filtering, encoding, decoding, escaping, unescaping, validation, etc. I want to say it again. Eight of the top 10 vulnerabilities map to this one freaking vulnerability. And it is in vast usage. Like it's out there like a lot. So then they talk about, you know, XSS and what it means, etc. And how to stay safe. Okay. Top 10 CVEs. Here, let me close this one. So we have, you can look these up yourself. These are not hard to find. The affected component is jQuery. 39% of the top 10 CVEs are associated to this one via jQuery. This one, CW707 via jQuery. Again, jQuery. Bootstrap. Finally, but we're right back to jQuery, and now jQuery UI, just to kind of, you know, give it that nice round off. So, I mean, jQuery is not doing so hot in 2023, you know, when it comes to these statistics here. You do have to consider that it is singular vulnerabilities and the percentage of like prevalence to this one vulnerability, and what is the highest or what is the most used entry point to this vulnerability. And so in this case, jQuery takes the cake. Okay. percentage of code bases containing high-risk vulnerabilities. Computer hardware and semiconductors. 88% of the code bases contain high-risk vulnerabilities. That's the stuff that runs our stuff. We haven't even talked about software. Manufacturing, industrials, and robotics. Basically the same. Retail and e-commerce? Not so much. Marketing tech? Not so much. Enterprise software, SaaS? Getting better. EdTech? Getting better. Energy and clean tech? Getting better. Financial services and fintech? Healthcare, etc., cybersecurity, internet and mobile apps, and so on and so on. And you can see that Internet of Things is the lowest. Virtual reality, gaming, entertainment, media, I don't know why the bar is off like this, it's kind of weird, is, Internet of Things is not the lowest, just the lowest bar. It's 50%, then 49%, then the lowest is automation, aerospace, aviation, automotive, transportation, and logistics. The bar is kind of weird here. But even just having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 of the top categories here being above 70% having high-risk vulnerabilities is, again, a shocking number. Percentage of top 10 licenses found in code bases. 92% have the MIT license, 89% have the Apache license 2.0, 81% have the BSD 3.1, 69% have BSD 2, 56 are public domain, 55 is ISC, 43 is Creative Commons, 42 is the GNU, 39 is Mozilla Public, and 36% is the unlicensed. So I would encourage you to look up these licenses individually. I've had to do it several times. Apparently I cannot retain all the differences, but just to kind of give you the brief overview, some of these mean that you have to sometimes just provide attribution. Sometimes it means that you're not actually allowed to use the thing unless you pay them or you have some kind of other agreement with them. And sometimes these licenses means go ahead and do whatever you want. The amount of license baggage that companies carry in because they want to use open source, it flies under the radar of like what you're actually accepting into your house. Percentage of top 10 licenses with conflicts. 17% with a Creative Commons attribution, 16 with share alike 3, it's 3 versus 4. Then you have a breakdown of the GNU, of Apache, GNU again, Creative Commons, and so on. So these are sectors that have a high percentage of open source license risk. So you can, I guess they kind of did the job for me if you want to have like a brief overview of the risk that people are taking. This is kind of like the percentage of people who are taking a risk. Percentage of code bases containing license conflicts, computer hardware and semiconductors. This is not giving me a lot of hope for the state of hardware manufacturing when I bet you companies that produce hardware and semiconductors are not fully aware of the facts that they have, of the fact that they have these licensing conflicts, and it can come and bite them in the ass at any point, and we accept this hardware into our machines. I mean, think about what could happen if everything ground to a halt because of a licensing conflict. Not that anybody would actually let that happen, but these are things that people seem to be willing to accept. And again, I mean, it's a huge jump from 92 to 81%. But even here, when we start talking about actual software-based things, above some of the top industries here that are software related are above 50%. We don't see a jump down to below 50% until about VR, right about here, VR, gaming, entertainment, media. And even down here at the bottom, marketing tech is the lowest with 20%. It's really not that great. Then we have AI tools. I don't care about AI tools. 88% of code bases analyzed in 2023 underwent risk assessments, which in this case would mean like somebody outside of the guys who did this report actually did a risk assessment internally. 49% of code bases that had risk assessments contained open source that had no new development in the last 2 years. Open source consumers need to improve maintenance. That's what this means, is that the open source contributors are not watching out for their own vulnerabilities or security issues, and neither is anybody who uses them or does NPM install anything. So then they break down kind of like their methodology. Okay,